like, the Wi-Fi network is back. I was kind of watching, like, I was playing. Mm-hmm. 10% of my focus was on playing. The other 90% was, oh, is it working?
Yeah.
Yeah. The internet's not perfect, guys. It's but not. We are here. Happy to be here. Someone said to say, sorry. Anyway, I glitched for a second. Yes, we are here on the stream. And thank you for joining us. Today we are going to be talking about the best riff in guitar history. We're going to go head to head.
I think we both picked like riffs nobody would pick too. Which
yeah.
I think is going to really spur some great comments today.
Yeah, yeah. And we're going to teach you both of the riffs. Mm-hmm. You're going to decide which one you like more. So we're kind of like battling in that sense.
Everybody but it's a good riff battle.
Yeah. Either way, you get to learn both, so that's so good. Oh, hola, Aldo. Someone said to say hi in Spanish. Let's see what's going on. Well, there was supposed to be a pedal of the week. That is not in the room presently.
Ah, okay.
So it will be next week's pedal
of the week. Next week we'll have a pedal of the week. Amazing.
Apologies. Well, on that note, let's talk a little bit about the giveaways we're doing at the end. If you've never seen the stream before, we do giveaways. Do you want to talk about them, Kent?
Yeah, today we will be giving away, we're doing a survival kit, and we are also going to give away a membership. You got to hang around till the end. At the end, we usually do a little trivia. Those who are watching on our YouTube channel, we are giving away a membership at the end, and those awesome members, you will get a chance to win the Guitareo survival kit, which is filled with lovely guitar accessories that everybody needs. So a tuner, the 360 Nexus tuner from Guitareo, which is awesome, one of my favorite tuners, and some strings, peg.
Sorry.
It's just Ayla glitching.
It's just, I'm throwing off the whole network. I'm taking up all of the bandwidth, so there's not a lot left. But what is cool is as a result, people are actually sharing where they're from, because they're like, total lack of sync from where I'm from. So we got people from the UK, Argentina, where my dad is from. That's awesome. It's not my dad, though. He's not on the stream. He'll watch later. He always watches later. He's at work. We got South Africa, Nigeria, Mexico, Sweden. That's very cool. Awesome. Well, because I didn't do the one thing I was supposed to do and bring the pedal of the week, let's just get right into the discussion. You know, what are the best guitar riffs of all time? I think it is something that changes for me by the day. So I didn't want to think too hard about what I would choose for today, because I'm sure it'll change in the next minute or two.
I changed my riff like 10 minutes.
You really did. And I was like trying to upload it and the Wi-Fi wasn't working too well. And I was like, oh no, am I going to make it in time? But I did make it in time, if you were wondering. Mm-hmm. And
definitely, if while we get into it, if you have your favorite guitar riff, throw it in the chat. I always love hearing what everybody's favorite tunes are. And it's we're talking about riffs because on Guitareo we have a new feature on the site, which is songs. Songs is fantastic. We've got tabs of tons of great tunes, which include the riffs we're teaching today, and probably most of your favorite riffs. We probably have the transcriptions up there. Mm-hmm. It's a fantastic feature. You can slow things down, loop things. You play along with the original recording. It's a really fantastic tool. And you can get it. If you're a Guitareo member, you can head on over there, click on the songs button. If you're watching on YouTube, we have a trial that you can sign up for at guitareo.com/trial. You can get a 7-day free trial. So you can check out all the songs, everything we have on Guitareo. I'm enjoying this. I'm a little distracted by this. There we go. So sign up for your 7-day free trial, and
reminds me
of the person like waving the plane in.
That's exactly
Ayla's
what I was going
you
for.
Into the
oh,
membership
hold
area.
Hold on, hold on. Come it slower, but keep coming, keep coming. This way to the membership. I'm sorry, what's distracting about me waving my arms around while you're trying to talk?
we've got a trial. Sign up for it. It's awesome if you're watching on YouTube. If you're in the member side, go check out the song section if you haven't already. It's fantastic. Our transcription team has been working really hard on that.
Oh, they have been. They really have been. Mm-hmm. I have to say, it's very funny. The beginning of these streams, I'm always so disconcerted for some reason. I don't know what it is. I mean, I'm slowly warming up. This always happens. But at the beginning of every stream, I'm like, I forgot the pedal. Oh, I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I just wanted to share that, and I don't actually know why. anyways, yeah. Let's get into the riffs.
Yeah, there's lots of good riffs in the chats already.
Oh, sorry.
I mean, Crazy Diamond, I love that riff.
One thing I need to say. Sorry, I totally interrupted you, but
Master
this is
puppets.
The one time I won't apologize because this is so important to point out. It's a feature of the site, and it is controversial. I think some people really are not into it, but I am very into it. You can listen to the song, of course, the original song linked to the tab. But you can also hear the MIDI version.
Oh, good old synthetic version.
It is so amazing to hear all of your favorite songs converted to a really kind of corny MIDI sort of thing.
Some are like that. Some of them do have like a fake distorted guitar sound, but you can remove everything and just play along with like MIDI taps. There's that option too.
I just love hearing like a really technical solo, but all like weird little MIDI
sounds. Right, and I think it's because it's the lack of feel with the MIDI. Everything is very like, you know?
Yeah, everything sounds like video game music.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah. All right. Let us get into the riffs. Maybe to decide who goes first, we can flip a pick. Do you want to be turtle side or sans turtle side?
I'll be sans turtle.
I knew you would choose that.
Mm-hmm.
Woohoo! All right.
Okay.
You're up. Sans Turtle.
Sans Turtle. Okay, we're gonna. The riff I picked.
Scene Tortuga. Sorry.
The riff I picked is a Rush riff. I love Rush. They're one of my favorite bands. First band I ever saw live.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was 13, 14. My best friend. And I went and bought tickets. I had very little money in my bank account, and I depleted it all to go see Rush.
Worth it.
Totally worth it. We were at, it was in Edmonton. We was at the Rexall Coliseum, big cement dome. And we were couldn't be further back, but it was amazing. And they were so good. And so Rush has a special place in my heart I don't know, just everything. Alex Lifeson's such a great guitar player. I think I saw him in Toronto. One time I was in Toronto and I was walking down an alleyway by a music store and there was a limo outside of the music store and a dude who looked very much like Alex Lifeson walked out of the music store into the limo and then went off.
He's actually the world's most famous Alex Lifeson impersonator.
Is that who I saw?
That's why he's in a limo. Everyone's trying to get at him, like the Beatles. You know, Alex Lifeson impersonator mania.
It was mostly just me trying to get at, you know, that's why.
It's for you. He has a security team because of you.
Because of me, yeah.
Rabbit fan.
So I picked the riff from Tom Sawyer, and there's many great riffs in Tom Sawyer. I love that tune. The pre-chorus riff, even the chords at the beginning are awesome, but I'm picking what starts out as a synth riff, but then turns into the guitar riff right before the solo. And I think it's really cool. It was one of the first tunes I heard where I distinctly knew it wasn't in 4/4 in that part, right? So it's like a different, so that was interesting. And like those who are into like prog music or metal, you know, hearing like a song that's like more commercial, like a Tom Sawyer, is a really good like gateway tune into that world where you're like, oh, that was kind of cool. What was that? So that was it for me. So thanks, Rush, for making me studious in music.
And Kent is very studious in music.
Astutely studious. but yeah, so we're going to have the tabs come up on the screen. I think I keep delaying like what the riff is. So yeah, there we go. It's the one, you know it. It's the one that... Whoops, not that.
It's my favorite riff in the song.
It's so good. It's like ridiculous how good this riff is. And I think, you know, we're talking about best guitar riffs of all time. I think... for me, this is like up there. And it brings me such joy playing it. And it's cool. It's a sequenced move. So again, being astutely studious person, I love studying what happens in these in riffs that I really like. So this is just thirds moving down. And I really love that. So it's just, I think of these in pairs. I find when I learn tabs, I try to group things together to make my life easier. So I'm going 7 to 9 and they're adjacent strings. So it's like 7 and 9 are a little pair, 6 and 7 are a little pair, and then 4 and 5 are a little pair. And I see those.
Right.
moving down. But then I play them one note at a time. So, and that part's the more straightforward part. And then the second part is almost the same, but he kind of takes like a little left turn. I said left and then I moved right, but that's fine. And then all, the first two are the same. Whoops, I'm making all the mistakes today. And then instead he's gonna kind of finish it off more pentatonic-y, which is also really neat. So that's the second half of the first bar, those who are. I love that.
So. I love how it just kind of like keeps tumbling.
Yeah, it feels like it feels like it's like somebody falling down the stairs or something.
Totally.
Yeah, like a comical fall, you know, where it's like.
But it's like with sunglasses on, so it's cool.
Totally, it's super cool. Sam pulled all the wrong notes today. I didn't get them out before.
Because you were saying switching between Fender and.
I've been exclusively playing a Fender guitars for like the past like week, and now I'm like, wait a minute, this isn't right.
Readjust.
And we mentioned that it wasn't in 4/4. It's not. So it's not 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, like most conventional music. This one is, I think, in 7. I've never really like, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4,
honestly,
five,
I feel
six,
like
and
most
seven.
Of
the drummer's giving,
riffs.
Drummer in the back's giving me the thumbs up.
So you know you got
you
it.
You got it, okay. So yeah, so it's in 7. So it's also really interesting because it drops a beat. So instead of going like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
I feel
seven,
like
five.
Almost all of the coolest riffs I've ever heard are in 7.
There, it's pretty sweet, and it's got this great like drop. It kind of like lilts a little bit, you
totally,
know. You're like, yeah.
Yeah,
things are cool. Whoop, and then you're like back, and you're like, oh, things are cool again. Whoop, and then you know what I mean? It's
yeah.
really neat, and then you can get in this cool groove as it cycles.
Yeah. Speaking of riffs in 7, obviously, Money by Pink Floyd is probably like the most famous riff in 7. There's also this riff. If you want to check it out, if you like odd meter stuff or want to like get into that, there's this riff at the end of All I Do by Derek Trucks.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's a good riff. It's a good one.
I don't know
one.
That one.
I wish I could play it off the top of my head. I mean, I don't
I
think
Derek
you want to sit
Derek
here
Trucks.
And watch me figure it out. So I'll just say, look it up, because it's worth it. Yeah, I agree though, that riff is so good.
Yeah, that whole song's awesome. Like,
it is.
I mean, like everything, I know we don't have the tab, but even those chords, right? The...
Yeah, super colorful.
And even the like. Like, all of that is just so cool. And I feel like, yeah, Rush is just like. It's just such a special place in my heart for, I don't know, just being like the nerdiest, most awesome rock band ever. They're just so good. And I don't know, I just every time I listen to them, it just blows my mind that they had the commercial success they did writing as cool music and as cool riffs as they did. Like it's almost like never the twain shall meet, you know? Like
I know.
People who write really cool stuff generally don't have a ton of commercial success. Or like really neat riffs or like musically interesting riffs. And maybe outside of the metal genre. In the metal world, there's a lot of really cool stuff and they get success in the metal world, but Rush isn't, they're kind of prog-ish.
Yeah.
In that vein.
Hard rock prog. Type stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, so it's really neat. And they're so globally known. Also being Canadian, having a Canadian band that is that huge. And it's just like, I feel like it's, becoming a Rush fan is like a rite of passage for guitar players.
And a rite of passion.
But
yeah, it is cool because, I mean, when you think about those iconic rock bands, especially from, like, 70s, 80s, whatnot, definitely the Canadian bands that, like, people loved in Canada didn't seem to reach nearly as far as Rush did.
Mm-hmm.
Like, only bands, I think, from Canada that I sometimes hear about, like, Triumph, people sometimes talk about.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I mean, Chilliwack, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that style. Yeah.
Avril Lavigne.
I mean, Nickelback.
She's well known. I mean, everyone knows Nickelback. Yep. That's so funny. I was just at 604 Records the other day filming my video. Speaking of which, that's their label, guys.
Interesting.
And guess what? They weren't there.
You're one step closer to Nickelback. Finally.
I know them by 1 degree of separation.
We had Dave Martone, who's.
Oh, yeah.
So
of course
you
did. He played on the Nickelback cover of Devil Went Down to Georgia.
Yeah.
Which I think as a concept is like insane that happened. Like in a very cool way, but it's so funny to me. that Nickelback did a cover of Devil Went Down to Georgia. Like, that's something I would come up with in a fever dream and be like, man, that would be so cool if that existed. And it does.
It really
Isn't
does.
Isn't that magnificent?
Dave Martone shreds at the end of it.
Oh, totally. Yeah, he's a great guitar player.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, tragically hip. I feel like they didn't have too much success outside of Canada, though.
That's true.
I feel like they were, like, a Canadian favorite. Anyway. But, yeah, Rush riffs.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. They're awesome. That's one of my favorite guitar riffs. I think every time I play it, doesn't matter how many times I play it, I always love it. And I think that's an indicator of a key riff for me. Mm-hmm. Like, there's certain riffs, you know, I've played in cover bands and I've played I've played those iconic guitar riffs everybody knows and loves. And some of them, it's just like, if I never play those again, I'm good. You know, like, but this one I could play every day for the rest of my life and I will love it every single time with equal passion.
Kent loves Cotton Eye Joe.
Where'd you come from?
Where'd you come from? Are we doing this right now? Cotton Eye Joe, I've been ready. Where'd you come from? Where'd you come from? Cotton Eye Joe. I feel like I'm at a Canucks game. I think that's enough, but you did a great job.
Yep.
Very nice. All right, I see two comments here to address. Wait, someone said Jeff died yesterday. Which Jeff?
Jeff Beck? No.
Wait.
What?
What? There's no way. Sorry, we have to stop to Google this. Which Jeff died?
Somebody said Jeff Beck passed away in the chat. There's no way. That's crazy.
He
did.
Oh.
What?
What?
That's insane.
That's crazy.
Oh my gosh. Oh, I love Jeff. Oh, man.
Dude, I might cry.
That's insane.
I actually am on the verge of tears. That's wild.
That's insane. I had no idea.
And to receive the news now,
live
on the stream, brutal.
That's insane.
Dude. Oh.
Well. Oh, that's so
sad. Sorry, I just
got
to take a second.
What a bummer.
That's a fucking
guitar player.
Oh, I almost swore. I mean, I did swear. Huge bummer. Major bummer. Sorry, guys.
Be listening to Blow by Blow later tonight, I guess. Oh, man.
Ah!
Oh,
that
goodness.
Sucks.
Mm.
Sorry. Ah.
Jeez. Well, I'm going to listen to Jeff Beck later. That makes me so sad. I love Jeff.
You're on the verge of tears, too.
I know. When I moved back to Edmonton, I did like a little Jeff Beck group. We played like a bunch of his tunes. Loved that. Oh. Oh. Oof.
Mm-hmm.
Right in the feels. Oof.
Damn.
Hmm. Crazy.
His solos on some of the Stevie songs he did, like on Talking Book. What's that song? He's like, dude, Jeff, Stevie. Stevie said that. What's that song? Looking for Another Pure Love.
Mm.
Oh, that's a beautiful solo.
Mm-hmm. Everything. All the records are great. If you're talking about like unique guitar players and like instrumental rock guitar that people love. It's like nobody does it better.
Yeah. Oh, man, his touch on the instrument was like unparalleled.
I have a live clip of his guitar solo. You want me to play that?
Yeah, okay.
Let's do it.
We got some...
Our audio team is on it.
Good.
We're going to play some Jeff Beck.
I'll cry when the cameras are... I'm kidding. I'm not afraid to cry.
Yeah.
Damn.
God, I love this song.
Thank you.
So good. I love that riff.
It wasn't Beck's Bolero, because now I'm very emotional. So good. What an epic song. And we were just talking about all the iconic people who played on it, because you had Jeff, of course, and then Jimmy Page on rhythm guitar, you were saying, and I know Keith Moon was the drummer, and that's why the cymbals are very loud in that song. That's awesome.
Man. Amazing. Well, if those of you have not checked out Jeff Beck, Blow by Blow is the record to listen to. If you never listened to Jeff Beck before, you got to listen to Blow by Blow. That's like top five best guitar albums ever.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And I mean, Stevie Wonder wrote some of the songs. Because We've Ended as Lovers is one of the most beautiful like guitar pieces I've ever heard. And then there's Scatterbrain.
Yeah, that record's
so good.
Yeah, everything about that record's good.
Rest in peace, Jeff Beck.
What a crazy turn of events for this stream.
Man.
We should just show that. We're talking about riffs. We should show that. But...
Yeah. Teach me, I want to know this one.
Yeah, okay, great. We're just going to teach a Jeff Beck riff, because we're here. We don't have notation on the screen, because we just found out how could we make it in 2 seconds. But it's great. It's an A minor pentatonic riff.
Great point,
riff.
Kent.
Yeah, it's all A minor pentatonic, and you're going to start on the fifth fret. And you'll see he starts with his ring finger sometimes. This is the middle of Beck's Bolero, for those who are keeping score at home of the tune. So two of those. Yeah. And then you go to the third fret of the fifth string. So you go. And then you got this nice little walk down.
That's a nice little walk down.
Some 5-4-3. Very like 60s British rock lick here.
Yeah.
And that's the first part. Yeah. And then he bends the fifth fret. Yeah, that's the riff. It's... does it twice. Then he goes up a minor third. I haven't played that song in a long time, but beautiful tune.
Beautiful. So good. Oh, and you're on a Les Paul, perfect.
He played a Les Paul in Blow by Blow.
He did, exactly,
as opposed to the Strat that
which everyone knows him for.
Kind of associates with him,
Very cool. Oh, man. Speaking of this Hendrix chord, it's actually a perfect transition to my riff. Sir, would you mind turning up my guitar just a wee little bit? Yeah, so I chose a very, kind of random riff, but I love it. Born to be Wild, under the organ solo. There's this very cool riff that the guitar plays. It's so good. A lot of it really just comes down to the right hand, but you play the Hendrix chord. If you don't know that and you like rock music, you better learn it. Also, if you like jazz.
If you like any music, period, you should learn this chord.
We should just name all the genres really quick, just to make sure.
Every genre.
Every genre, yeah. So Hendrix chord, we got a 7th fret A string, 6th fret of the D string, 7th fret of the G string, and then the 8th fret of the B string, and you play down, up, down. And what's crazy is, up until yesterday when I looked at this song tabbed on our website, I thought it was just two hits. I don't know why. I've listened to this song like who knows how many times, and I've never heard that it's so strange.
That's funny. I feel like everybody has songs like that. We had that. I had that with Immigrant Song. Same thing when I went on the on the website. I was like, wait a minute. That's how it is. I've been playing it wrong for years.
Yeah, and then I feel like your mind does this weird thing where you know a riff so well. It's so ingrained in your mind that like you hear the song, and until it's pointed out to you, you're always going to autofill to what you think it is. So I just never heard that extra strum. But yeah, once you do that.
It definitely was a ghost strum for you.
Yeah. Literally, yeah. And then we got some muted strums. Up, down, up, down. And then two more of the chord, and those are upstrokes. And then down, up, down, up, down, up. And to get that muted sound, you want to just release pressure with your fretting hand. And try to add some vibrato to the chord. I think that's one of the reasons why it's one of the best rock chords. I actually just realized this, because something about the way your hand is shaped when you play it, it makes it a lot easier to really dig in and get like vibrato on the chord. So it has that much more attitude and soul to it. Versus. And then with vibrato. It's a huge difference. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I love that riff. To be honest, it's my favorite riff of that song, which is Sing a Lot, because I think the main riff of that song is extremely cool. And yeah, someone else asked if I know Soda Stereo, probably because I mentioned Argentina. Obviamente, me encanta. They're like the best band from Argentina. Mm-hmm. So good. And their lead singer, Gustavo Cerati, I think that's his name. He's like the Latin American Mick Jagger. Oh. At least my dad claims.
Crazy.
I wonder if that'll be contentious. But I feel like a lot of people love him. He, like, his solo stuff is also amazing. Mm-hmm. Oh, man. What a good band, too. All right. Well, we've taught our riffs.
I saw the Jeff Beck.
I know. Stop bringing it up. Sheesh. If you guys could choose, which riff do you think is cooler? That... one niche part of Born to be Wild that I taught, or
the one niche part of Tom Sawyer
before the solo section.
I picked the Jeff Beck riff we taught in the middle of that.
Actually, yeah, I might choose that
riff
one too.
Riff of the day for sure. Well, all right.
Well, on that note, when I was writing this show run out, Kent wrote a note, and you said something special to be determined.
What?
Was that not you?
No, who wrote that in there?
I don't know who wrote that then. Was it you, Ellie?
Cool.
It was a ghost.
A ghost wrote it.
Ghostwriter. That's what they mean
when
they
special,
say.
So I mean, I did teach that Jeff Beck riff like right off the cuff.
That is special, but you can't replace what I'm about to do. Because I was inspired by you last time reading that AI generated note.
Oh.
And I am existentially terrified of AI, but ChatGPT, whatever it's called, whatever the program people are using to write stuff with AI, I do love that. It's very funny. And I asked the AI to write some jokes for us.
Oh my gosh.
Some guitar themed jokes.
Oof.
Are you ready? Let me see. Okay. I said, write a joke about guitars. AI said, why did the guitar player bring two sets of strings to the gig?
What?
In case one set broke, because that would be string theory. I can't say I get it, but the next one is actually very funny.
Okay.
You'll like this one, Kent. Mm-hmm. Write a joke about a mustached guitarist named Kent who adores surf rock. I said that to the AI.
I was like, wow, the AI really knows me super well. Yeah,
the AI said, why did Kent, the mustache guitarist who adores surf rock, have a surfboard on his guitar case?
Why?
Because he wanted to be ready to shred both on land and sea. Where did that come from? Oh my God, that's amazing. That's so funny. Thank you to our sound guy who had that locked and loaded. Ready to shred on land and sea. Oh, this is a great one. Read a joke about Ayla. She plays guitar, has 2 feet for cool sneakers, and loves ramen. I said that.
So the love for ramen is real.
It's real. And I do have 2 feet for shoes, cool sneakers.
Really? I always thought you had 3. Crazy.
You learn something new every day, Kent. Life's for learning. So AI said, AI. I'm saying it like it's a name. Like it's just like a singular person.
Ms. AI wrote to us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Why did Ayla put a noodle in her guitar case?
Why?
So she can strum and slurp at the same time. It's how she rockin' ramen. The sound in the middle of the punchline. I say punchline very loosely, but you know what? It couldn't have gone better than that. Okay, I have two more. Is that okay?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, just sitting here.
I have the jokes open, and I don't have the chat open, so I don't know if people even like this. I'm just going to keep going.
It's fine. Yeah. Best thing you can do is assume they're enjoying it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's how I lead my life. Okay. I said, write a joke about Guitareo. Got the wrong joke open, guys. Yeah. Write a joke about Guitareo. The AI said, why did the student subscribe to Guitareo? To have access to all the right chords, in quotations for some reason, to become a true virtuoso and never again play a flat performance. Oh, that's funny.
I like that chords are in brackets. Like,
I know.
We're going to teach you how to play some chords today.
In quotations, yes. Let me see. Okay, one more. Write a knock-knock joke about Ayla the guitarist. Knock-knock.
Who's there?
Ayla.
Ayla who?
Ayla, play some music on my door while I wait here.
What? No sound for that?
Wow.
I'm sorry, that is so funny to me.
Oh, what a time to be alive.
That's so good. That's the best one by far, I'm sorry.
That was incredible.
That's such a good one. Anyways, on that note, I'm thinking it might be time for a giveaway. But first, someone wrote a really good joke in the chat. Said, what is the best and ideal way to invite a guitarist to a party? You should always invite them cordially.
Cordially? Oh my God.
I have to say the best part is, what is the best and ideal way to invite a guitarist to a party?
Not just the best, but also
best
ideal.
And ideal. That is also absurdly funny to me. That is,
I like that.
Wildly
That's a good joke.
Funny.
Well done.
Yeah. Thank you to Robert Atkins. Do you think any relation to Dave Atkins, our boss? The big boss?
Probably not.
No. No? Who knows, though? Yes.
Was chords in quotations? Cordially?
Cordially.
Invite them cordially.
There's so much to analyze about that. Like, why chords are in quotations? Like, what? I'm gonna have a full-on philosophical crisis.
What is a
right
chord
here.
Even, right? Like, chords.
What even is it?
What even are chords?
I don't know. That's a good question. And what separates a chord from a, let's say, a refrigerator? Yeah. I'm talking at the epistemological level.
Yeah. I just play guitar, man.
No one pays me to do this. No one wants me to do this. And that's the end. Okay, we have to do the giveaway. And we always do this. We leave it to the last second to come up with a trivia question to decide the winner. And we are going to do a trivia question to decide the winner.
Great.
And we left it to the last second, so we don't know it. That was like, I really covered all the bases and then did it again.
Okay, great. So we don't really know it. Okay, this is for the YouTube chat.
And you're going to win a free annual membership to Guitareo.com.
Mm-hmm,
if you win, not just for being here. Sorry.
Yeah, that'd be nice. But no, just the winner. Let's say the riff that I taught, I guess I taught two. Let's say the riff that Ayla taught. Who is the band that wrote that riff?
Who is the band? It's there, guys. There's your hint.
Yeah, that tab.
Yeah.
Steppenwolf. There we go.
Yeah. Is that Enrique Preciado?
Enrique, congratulations. Woo-hoo! You won a annual Guitareo membership. Now for the next stream, you get to hang out in the member side. Gonna be awesome. Congratulations to you. And you'll get access to all of our songs, all the tabs that are on there, all the lessons, our method, our coaches, all of that good stuff.
So congratulations. I love how someone commented, oh, that one.
Oh, that one, yeah. It's helpful, yeah.
I mean,
helpful.
Yeah, that's what you would say in real life. Like, oh, that one. It's just, it's so amazing to me, like, to actually type out those little expressions you say.
Mm-hmm.
because fair enough. Like, yeah. That's how I'd respond in real life. Oh, that
one. Before I forget, Enrique, you got an email to get your membership.
Team@musora.com. team@musora.com.
Yes, or guitario.com. Either one will work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you hear my shoe squeak there? I got the gazelles on. They're getting less squeaky as I'm wearing them more.
Good squeak.
But they are very squeaky shoes.
Solid squeak.
Yeah. I like them though. As I told my colleagues this morning, they did give me street cred when I went to the skate park. I'm not a skater, to be clear. I'm not going to pretend I am. I'm a big time poser. But I happened to be with someone who also didn't really skate. I'm not going to lie. But mm-hmm. We went to the skate park, and all the skaters there were like, hey, nice shoes. Mm-hmm. Wow. That's cool. Because I felt scared being there. Very scared. But they liked my pink Adidas gazelles. Mm-hmm. All right. Now we should do the trivia for the members. The members are going to be eligible to win.
I always point the wrong way. There.
You actually always do, and you always say, oh, I always point the wrong way.
Yeah, I never learn. I'm a slow learner. Here.
That's okay. And again, my favorite shot with Kent slightly out of focus, but still in it. Also, someone correctly pointed out that I spelt out T-E-A-M, team, in the email, but not Musora, which is the word that would probably be less familiar. To be clear, that's M-U-S-O-R-A.
T-E-A-M at Musora.com.
I'm sorry. No, I'm not.
Okay, let's do our trivia for the members.
Also,
go for
someone
it.
Someone just said, is this shoegaze rock? I'm guessing because I mentioned my shoes.
Oh, I like that.
And if you think about it, you're all shoegazing right now. Ow, my leg's cramping. Oh, you go ahead with the giveaway. I'm in pain.
Okay, let's do...
Sheesh.
Wow.
Sorry. Just keep going. Don't
keep going. Okay, well, I'll just pretend nothing's happening.
I stretch one leg, I have to stretch the other one.
Oh, I see. Okay. Great. Well, just I'm very distracted right now. I'm just going to let this play out a little bit. And then while I think of a trivia question here. Okay. Trivia will be...
What was the Jeff Beck song that we heard?
We heard. I taught the riff to it as well.
That's very true.
Bueller. Blow by Blow is the record. It's not on that record, though. Good record.
Yeah. Yen said squeak cred, Ayla.
Squeak cred.
Nice.
Okay, we said the name of the tune in the stream, right?
We did. Definitely.
Okay.
If no one got it.
Oh, there we go. Frank
we got it. Frank White.
Woo-hoo. Good job, Frank.
Nice job.
Beck's Bolero is correct. That's a great tune. I love that song.
Yeah.
So good. The original recording is awesome. It is like a star-studded band. I can't remember. The whole band is like, they're all from like famous.
Yeah, well, Jimmy Page, Keith Moon.
I think I can't remember who played bass. Was it John Paul Jones playing bass?
Probably.
I think it was.
I think it might have been.
Yeah. And then the keyboard player too is, I can't remember his name.
You can Google it.
Yeah. Anyway, great recording. It's on Beck Ola, the very first Jeff Beck album. Super good.
Yeah.
Jeff's great. Everybody's homework assignment is to listen to Blow by Blow tonight. If you've never listened to that record, it's been a while since you've listened to it. Everybody should have a top to bottom listen to Blow. It's a masterpiece. George Martin produced that record. The guy produced Beatles. Produced it.
That's why the string arrangements are so good.
Yeah, Stevie Wonder wrote 3 songs, I think, on that record for Jeff. It's pretty good. It's outstanding if you've never heard it. So, excellent. So, Frank, please email Ayla@guitario.com to get all of your so we can ship wrong way again. We're gonna ship this out to you, the awesome Guitareo Survival Kit. Those of you who are interested in the Survival Kit and maybe and didn't win, but want to just get it on your own, you can find it on the Guitareo website and you can order it. You don't have to put up your hand. It's all good.
I actually had something to say. Beck's Bolero, just because we were talking about it. It was Jimmy Page, Keith Moon, John Paul Jones, you're right. Mm-hmm. And then Nicky Hopkins, who I actually am not familiar with. He was the keyboard player, but he, I think it seems like
Stones, right?
Very prominent like session player. Like he played on a lot of songs by the Stones and the Kinks and the Who, mm-hmm. the Beatles.
Crazy.
You know, the big boys.
Mm-hmm. Well, mm-hmm. congrats, Frank, on winning. Yeah. You're going to love the survival kit. Everything you, if it's been a while since you changed your strings, you're going to get some new strings in the mail. You can throw those on.
Yeah.
Amazing. all right.
So are we going to do the Q&A on here?
I can't remember. Are we... Yeah, the Q&A has got to be live. Okay,
cool. All right. Usually the Q&A is exclusive for members, but you're in luck. The network is down today. So everyone gets access, but I mean, we're only going to answer the the members' questions.
Before I go into it, there was a question on YouTube. What's inside the survival kit? It is a Nexus 360 tuner, two sets of strings, acoustic, electric, both from Guitareo. The tuning winder, the thing, you know, that thing. And then the survival kit, some picks, polishing cloth.
Oh, survival guide.
The survival guide, sorry. And then I think that's everything that's in it. I don't think I'm missing anything.
What's in the box?
What's in the box, yeah.
I'd like to imagine that there is a survival kit in the survival kit.
Yeah. What's inside the survival kit? It's a survival kit.
that's like an AI joke.
Yeah.
Somehow.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There we go. Perfect. So, yeah, lots of stuff. Check out. So, members, you can check it out. Those on watching on YouTube, you can also purchase that on guitareo.com/shop.
Yeah.
Check that out.
All right, let's get into some questions. We had one from Vincent.
Yes, I can...
Start with that one.
So Vincent asked us some ominous, like...
Is there like a soccer team up there? Like, what are they doing?
So Vincent's question. My son, who plays guitar, wants to play Beat It from Michael Jackson. And the song is the solo by the late Eddie Van Halen. What would be the way for him to bluff through this solo instead of having to really learn and nail it? Sounds like what I do when I have a cover band gig.
Yep.
Yeah. He isn't as good as Van Halen yet, even though he is, of course, Dutch, and Van Halen was half Dutch.
I'm sure he's close. He's got all the right ingredients.
Yeah, I think the recipe's there for sure.
Yeah.
That's a whole topic, how to fake your way through solos.
Yeah.
But I think...
Especially that one specifically.
Yeah. I think, it's tough. I think sometimes when I learn solos and I have a really tight turnaround, I go through the solo and find the like key points of the solo. So in that solo, it's the tapping for me that really sticks out. So if he was going to spend his time on a part of that solo, it's like those tappy bits.
Yeah.
And I think if you get a general sense of the direction of the solo, you don't have to like go into the nitty-gritty. That's one of those, there's a few songs out there that are like, you have to play the solo, don't put it out. Like if you're gonna play like Don't Stop Believing, you have to play that guitar solo. Like you can't, there's no room for liberty in that guitar solo.
Unless you want to be the most hated person in the room.
Yeah, people will be very disappointed if you don't play that guitar solo note for note. I feel like Beat It's like kind of crossing that line. I think you can fudge a little bit of it.
I mean, yeah, I think the melodic parts you'd have to get, but then there's that one lick, that really hard one, because it's like that sped up and like the stretch is like huge. It's really hard. So, I mean, if you played something around those pitches, but like something else, but fast, like something like that.
I think sometimes when you get to those really speedy licks that might take like months to get down, you can kind of just generalize them and be like, it sort of sounds like this and like I can do it
something
that way.
Fast with these notes.
Yeah. I will say like most people won't know. Maybe you'll know, Vincent, because you of course play guitar. So you might be like, those aren't the right notes. But most people will... probably be like, well, cool. So, you know.
Honestly, people are impressed by flashy things. Like, for example, Eruption, people are most impressed by the... That's not the tapping part. How does it go? Oh, why is my guitar so quiet? Anyways, that's probably like the easiest part of the solo to play, but it's probably the one that the most... non-guitar players would be like awestruck by.
Mm-hmm.
So keep that in mind if you want to simplify things but still knock people's socks right off.
Yeah, but I think in general the big gist of all of that is find the like main points, like the identifiable points of a solo, and
the
then spend time
parts,
learning those, and then anything insanely technical, you can kind of bridge that without most people knowing. It would be good to spend time to learn what Eddie did. It's a great solo. If you're going to spend time on a solo, that's a good one to learn. Yeah, it's a great tune. Even the opening parts, even if he's not going to do the solo, like Steve Lukather's parts in that tune are just killer. Like
that. I didn't know he played on that.
That's him.
What? That's crazy. For those who don't know, Steve Lukather, he's amazing. He was a guitar player for Toto, so like Rosanna.
And like everything, like a huge studio musician.
And I think I saw him live with Ringo Starr.
Oh, cool.
Because he plays in his all-star band.
Nice. Yeah, Steve's amazing. Yeah. One of the best guitar players. Him playing the rhythm part.
Sorry?
Yeah, that's him playing the rhythm part in Beat It. So he doesn't play the solo.
I just wanted to say I met him one time and it was really cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I took a picture with him.
Yeah, he's great. One of my favorites. I don't know if we have Beat It yet on the site. It's on our list of songs to do as well, Vincent. I don't know if it's on the tabs yet, but I have a big list of songs we're going to be adding. And I'm 100% sure it's on our list. I just don't know if it's done yet or not. So it is coming. We will have the solo tabbed out and all that goodness.
I need to stop interrupting you. I'm sorry.
It's all good.
I'm just excited.
Anyway, so we're going to move on to, if you have any questions in the members area, you're going to please throw them in the questions tab.
Sorry, there's just one thing.
Anyway, so we're going to talk about.
There's just one thing I wanted to say. I'm sorry.
Go for it.
And then I'll
so the
not
next question
I'll
we
never
have,
talk Jens, again. I get it now. Yeah, I've learned my lesson, but I'm still going to go ahead.
Jens's question is...
I'm really passionate about this, so I have to answer. It's in the YouTube area, so I'm also going against the rules. But just someone mentioned flamenco, and they mentioned Paco de Lucia, who's awesome.
So good.
Yes, and yes, I love that. And if anyone wants to read a great book that is sort of like talking about an amazing fantasy story that surrounds flamenco guitar playing, read Frankie Presto and the Magic Strings.
I've never read that.
It's one of the most heartwarming and awesome book I've read, like probably in my life. Mm. I've read like a good amount of books. I loved it. It was so good.
Crazy.
Sorry.
I'm gonna have to check that out. I have nothing to say now.
Finally, I stopped talking and it's the wrong time. I guess my issue is timing. I'm not going to read what someone said. Never mind.
Questions in the YouTube chat. In the member side. All members, you can ask us anything you want. Related to riffs, not even. Anything else. All right. Jens wrote, Kent, since you're a big jazz guy, what's your favorite jazz guitar riff ever?
That's a good one.
That is a good one. I was top of my head. So in the jazz world, there's like jazz riffs that are like not guitar specific that a lot of people know. So like the most famous one as of late is the lick. That's the lick. You'll hear that in a lot of people use it. It was kind of a joke for a little bit in the jazz world. So,
Donnelly.
No, I would say Wes Montgomery's solo in 4-on-6 is pretty sweet.
Like the studio version or the live at
Both
at the Half Note?
Both are very good, but the one that has the...
Oh, that's Spoken at the Half Note.
Yeah, that.
With the Winston Kelly Trio?
Yeah,
oh,
super good.
Oh, I love that record.
Yeah, and when he does that... I'm going to forget it.
Yeah.
That little like whole tone lick I think is like super cool.
Yeah. Amazing.
And he played it all with his thumb. I don't know how he did that.
It's crazy. Apparently he started playing with his thumb because when he was practicing late at night, he didn't want to wake anyone up.
Yeah, I think he wanted to like hide it from his wife. They bought like a pricey guitar. I think that was the original story I heard. So
that's funny. I thought it was just because he was he's trying to be considerate, but.
I thought he was trying to be sneaky. I'm going to have to check.
Me too.
All of that. I guess he's ultimately was being sneaky.
It's
underlying
true.
Under both sneaks was part of it.
You got to communicate with your partners.
But yeah, I think off the top of my head, that might be one of my favorite riffs. But I've been listening to a lot of Keith Jarrett lately.
True.
And the opening riff we played at the beginning of the show was a Keith Jarrett riff that I was learning this week. I thought it was pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think of other great. Oh, Pat Metheny. That on its own is such a great riff. I don't know.
I love Phase Dance.
Yeah.
That's a cool one.
Yeah, all that.
All the like 80s stuff you did with Lyle Mays is like. Such
totally.
A vibe, guys.
Yeah. Schofield's got a lot of great riffs. The record A Go-Go is like filled with like killer like funk jazz fusion guitar riffs. It's a great album. I don't know if I could pick one. The Wes Montgomery solo is like very iconic though. I think a lot of it's like that's like every jazz guitar player maybe doesn't learn it verbatim, but we all like pick and choose from that. It's like every jazz guitarist, you know, it's like that solo is like, yeah, that's like one of the best jazz guitar solos ever recorded. I don't think any jazz guitarist would debate that. That's like one of the best recorded jazz guitar solos. Chesapeake wrote, actually, I should pass off to you too, because I know you're a jazz fan as well. Any jazz riffs you like?
Jazz riffs. I mean, it depends what the definition of riff is. I mean, I love some Charlie Parker heads. There's some great ones. I mean, Donna Lee is like the most famous one, probably. There's also, which one is this? That's so bad. I used to know that one, like the back of my hand, but it's been a couple years. Whatever. If you don't know jazz, it'll all sound the same to you. It doesn't matter.
Oh, shots fired.
And then, just speaking of Wes Montgomery, because he's by far my favorite jazz guitarist ever, there is another song off of the Smoking Out the Half Note record called Impressions.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it was Confirmation. That's what it was. Sorry.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Confirmation was the coming back to me. But yeah, there's Impressions, which is like a modal jazz thing. It's kind of like So What? But it's like a Coltrane tune. It's his playing on that is so fantastic. There's that. Last thing I'll say, Giant Steps, Joe Pass off of Virtuoso number 2. Mm-hmm. That's such a great recording. And also, fun fact, it's what Q-Tip sampled for Let's Ride, the rap song.
Right.
That is probably like his most famous song, like as a solo artist.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that,
sorry,
that's...
I was like, Joe Pass? Interesting. Yeah, I was like, no, Q-Tip. Okay, great.
Yeah, so the sample for Let's Ride, the Giant Steps one, is taken from Giant Steps by Joe Pass.
Crazy.
There you go.
Fun fact for the day.
No more jazz talk. People don't want that.
Chesapeake wrote, I searched the song catalog, but I don't see Tom Sawyer. Is this riffing Guitareo? It should be. I looked it up right before the stream, so I don't know why it wouldn't be showing. You're not seeing it. Please shoot your mentor a message, and they will help you figure it out and send you the direct link. It is on there, though. I know. I'm like 100% sure of that because I looked it up right before the stream. So...
Last question from Shining Soul and the Wild Headbanger. It's the best name. Every single time either of us says that name, we're like, that should be a band name. It's great.
Every time.
Every time. Who's your favorite metal guitarist?
Mm.
It's a good one.
Randy Rhodes, maybe?
Mm.
I love Randy Rhodes. Yeah. Like, all the stuff on the Aussie records are so good. I don't know. Like, I'm not sure where to draw the line on, like, my, like, yeah. Like, I wouldn't say Joe Satriani is a metal guitarist, but he employs a lot of techniques that are used
Yeah,
that style.
I probably wouldn't see him as a metal guitarist, but I agree with you. You know he, like, toes the line.
Yeah, or, yeah. Like a Tosin Abasi is, like, it's more, yeah. Like, prog, but it's not, they kind of have some, like, metal breakdown kind of things.
Yeah.
Anyway, I feel like metal, I would say that I would put Randy Rhodes as my favorite.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Though also, I think Dave Mustaine is pretty amazing. And a really interesting thing, I think, when it comes to music, we don't always talk about like the psychological part and the mindset part. And I didn't know this till I watched Some Kind of Monster recently, which is this really absurd Metallica documentary that was made when they were making Saint Anger. Mm-hmm. It really truly is Spinal Tap brought to life. It's one of the most ridiculous things I've ever seen and interesting. But yeah, Dave Mustaine, for those who don't know, I mean, he was kicked out of Metallica and then kind of always compared everything he did to Metallica, which is a losing battle because Metallica, you know, was such a huge band. But then it's so interesting that Megadeth has been ridiculously influential.
Mm-hmm.
Dave Mustaine is revered by guitar players.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, to him, though, that doesn't matter as much as it could because of that outlook. And I really resonate with that because I feel like that's something I've experienced in certain parts of my life as well.
Mm-hmm.
But it's really interesting. Dave Mustaine, if you're watching this, which is like, you're definitely not, but you're so good. You're so good. You don't need to, honestly, I think Megadeth is so freaking good.
Yeah.
Dude. Rock on, Dave Mustaine. Yeah. We love you. Dave Mustaine forever.
Yeah. Megadeth's amazing.
Yeah.
Some killer guitar riffs.
Rust in peace, baby.
Yeah, we're gonna have some of those, some Megadeth coming out on the song section soon. I don't think they're done yet. They're
coming. Do you know which ones? Or can we not say?
I can say.
Please say Tornado of Souls.
Oh, I happen to have the. What are we working on? I spelled Mega wrong. I was like, why is nothing coming up? Megadeth.
Holy Wars.
Oh yeah. A couple are up. Holy Wars. Punishment is Due. We have in our song section. Killing is My Business and Business is Good is coming. Soon. Those are the only two we have. We're gonna add more.
That's
a little
cool.
Bit later.
That's awesome.
Yep.
Should get Peace Cells on there.
Yeah, we'll have to do some more at some point. Oh yeah, Symphony of Destruction. Destruction. Wow, I can say any of that. Symphony of Destruction. We should definitely put that one in there. Hangar 18. Oh, yeah, that's another classic too. Oh,
those man. Are great. Those are great.
I feel like a teenager again.
Megadeth bringing me back to my youth. That's you. That's my impersonation of you.
That's how you sound. I thought it was me. I thought it was my internal monologue going on. It's crazy.
Someone said, we're at the point of the stream where Kent looks like he's regretting his life decisions. Yeah, try sitting next to me for an hour.
Wow. I do not regret my life decisions. At least not these ones.
That's awesome. That's awesome to hear, Kent. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, on that note, I guess it's time for us to jam our way out of the stream.
You know what we should jam on?
Thanks for tuning in, by the way.
Yeah, we'll be back next week at the same time, same place, same bat channel. I can't remember what we're doing next week.
Don't put me on the spot again, please. You know what? In the future, I'll know.
In the future. Off the top of my cool. head. It's all good. Next week, we'll be chatting, same time, same place. Come hang out. We'll play some tunes, have some fun, and it's going to be a great time. We'll have more giveaways. It's going to be a blast.
Yeah.
We should jam on Thelonious, just the A section.
I don't know it off the top of my head. I'm not gonna lie.
You'll pick up the hook, and then I know the melody.
Okay.
So. Oh, I'm playing the wrong tune. What is it? No, it is right. Just kidding.
Can I see your footing
there? It's all F sharp minor.
No, I know. Sorry, I meant the second chord.
Yeah.
Oh, I get it now. Okay, guys, okay.